Hey everyone, I'm Duke of the Bump. Welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Land for the Game Boy. So we had sort of a typical Mario world, is what I would say World 1 was. I mean, it was very Super Mario Brothers 1-1-esque. Except for the temple, or the pyramid, or whatever that last stage was, 1-4. And then World 2 was sort of a water world. I mean, 1-4 was all water, but 2-1 through 2-3 had all those fish jumping out of the water and such. And now we're on World 3, which is kind of a Super Mario Brothers esque level with mole heads everywhere. And there are some weird enemies in this game. Like, you have the Goomba and the Koopa, which is like, I guess that's just obligatory. I mean, you have to include something that harkens back to the Mario Brothers games of old. And the Piranha Plants. But other than that, it's like a, I wonder if I can get those without killing myself. Alright. Man, that was a fast fall. I'm lucky I was actually able to, Bullet Bill! There's another Mario throwback. Whoa! Jesus. I have to say, it's pretty nice being able to play this and actually being able to see the screen. Because, I mean, on the original Game Boy, I mean, A, everything was like this hideous shade of green. But B, the screen was so blurry that anything with, like, a scrolling background became just impossible to see. See, that's why Tetris was so brilliant. Because it was a game, I mean, that game was just perfect for the Game Boy. It was all one, you know, the screen itself didn't move at all. Aww. Man, those suckers are fast. Alright, well, I actually got the power-up mushroom now, so hopefully I should be at an advantage. Whoa! Oh. Well, that didn't last long. But yeah, Tetris. What a brilliant game. Not only is it a brilliant game, it's a brilliant Game Boy game. Like, releasing that, I mean, that was the pack-in, right? Releasing that as a pack-in for the Game Boy is just the smartest thing Nintendo's ever done. Because it's the perfect game for the Go. You know, when you play Tetris, you don't realize that if you try to play a game like Mario, everything's going to be way too blurry because the screen never moves, it's just the pieces. And the pieces don't move fast enough. Well, I guess they do later on, but at first, the pieces don't move fast enough for you to realize that there's going to be a problem. So you play Tetris and you're all, the Game Boy is awesome! Wow, this is the coolest thing ever! And then you get another game like Mario Land and you realize, oh. I mean, it was still playable. I'm making it sound worse than it was. It was definitely playable, but, oh god. That doesn't look easy. But, you know, it was not, wasn't perfect. It was like trying to play the original Game Boy Advance before they put the backlight in. Or the front light, I should say. I mean, it was playable if you were sitting directly underneath the sun. Of course, you know, you kids watching probably grew up with iPhones, and, you know, you don't realize how bad we used to have it. LCD screens used to be pretty terrible. Aw. Oh, wait. Okay. That's cool. I thought it would disappear. Oh, it did disappear that time. Maybe I can still make that jump. Alright. I mean, not that I really need more extra lives, but, you know, every little bit helps. Plus, I might get a fire flower. Or a rubber ball flower. Alright. So yeah, handheld game systems have come a long way since Game Boy. There's still some really cool Game Boy games, though. The Zelda game on the Game Boy is fantastic. It's one of the best. And you know, this game, you know, I'm digging it. It's not perfect, but you know, it's weird. It's like a really weird Mario game. It's fun. And it's not quite as short as I remember it. So it's still playing like the pseudo-Egyptian music, even though there's no Egyptian motif in this level. Man. That might be like the emulator screwing up. I'm glad that's not happening more often, because that is really crunchy. Let's see if I can angle my shot to take out that spider. Dang it. There we go. I guess if you don't have a fire flower there, you're supposed to just get close enough to like lure it to come down and then just run past it. Oh man, that is a narrow platform. Oh god. That was really close. I mean, in some ways, the controls actually feel better than Super Mario Brothers, because I don't think I would have made that. Like, I wouldn't have landed on that narrow platform if this was Mario 1. I would never have been able to have been that precise. Well, dang. Well, we lost our flower power, but we were big once more, so it all worked out. I mean, it's weird, like, the game feels good and janky at the same time. Like, it's kind of hard to describe. Oh god. I almost hit my head on that stalactite. I don't know, I think they did an okay job with this game. Ugh. Man. I apologize for what's going on there. I'm using Visual Boy Advance, which is what's supposed to be the best Game Boy emulator. I don't know, maybe I have the graphic settings. Like, I turned VSync on, maybe I shouldn't have done that. So, the same pseudo-Egyptian music, even though it's the overworld now. And, you know, not Egyptian at all. We have Moai heads everywhere. Of course, I mean, this isn't really Egyptian music. I say that because, you know, that's the stereotype we think of when we think of Egyptian music. But real Egyptian music probably didn't sound anything like that. I mean, for one, they would have used instruments and not, you know, a sound chip. That's probably the main difference. There's not going to be anything in any of these bosses there. Oh. Just in the question mark block. That was a good bank shot there. These big enemies take 2 fireballs to kill, which isn't really that big of a barrier to killing them. I don't really like this music that much. Sounds like the music that we'd be playing in a Looney Tunes, one of those episodes of the Looney Tunes about the tortoise and the hare. I think There was at least one Looney Tunes cartoon about the tortoise and the hare, right? That would be like the Turtles theme music. Just this sort of dopey, slow doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo. I do like this music, though. I'm glad it's featured more than just the one time. Whoa. Water effects. Good job, Game Boy. Oh, God. I'm having a little bit of trouble, like, turning every time I want to. Like, the turning... Like, there's an extra... I don't know. A little janky. No big deal, though. It's a very dignified-looking Moai statue. Did that thing take 3 hits? Jeez. What did it look like? Made of fireballs? Whoa! I guess there are only 3 levels in these stages. Eh, I'm Wario! Oh crap. Now what? Well, that didn't work. I have to kind of leapfrog off those boulders. Well, at least it put a mushroom right there. That's nice of it. I was hoping they would put a fire flower right there too. But no such luck. Wow. Well, I still have 19 lives, so I'm not too worried about this. This is going to be a lot trickier without fire, though. Oh god. There we go. That was a really dumb-looking boss. This is Moai head with, like, these stubby, chubby legs and arms. Alright, this is surely the real Daisy. I mean, after all this... You're welcome, Daisy. Maybe she's saying old Daisy. Doesn't really make it clear that that's a different bit of dialogue. Alright, come on, fire flower. Alright. Well done, Duke. Well done. Oh yeah! It's like the Japanese level. This is awesome. Alright, well, tune in tomorrow for World 4 of Super Mario Land. I like this music too. Bye, everyone.